is a video. Okay, Rosemary, we're getting ready for your entrance.
What time is it?
Madeline, who is this?
About a quarter to one, to 1 o'clock.
Hello, hi.
What would you tell her?
She looks familiar, but I don't know.
Is everyone getting ready?
Oh, that's right.
Hi, Teresa. Angelica, Janet.
Thank you. godmother, very happy home godmother. It's one of the boys. Thank you, I appreciate it. Madeline, too.
Yes, thank you.
And we're all happy to be here to wish you well. You look wonderful. And we just want to wish you the best. Congratulations.
I just composed a little something that I would like to read to her. Okay. And I named it The Realities of Motherhood. Spelling out the word mother. M. M is for that miraculous moment of giving birth, and suddenly you are a mother of not one, but two. O. O is for the countless times you will say, "Oh my God, look what you boys have done." And then try to figure out which one had a bun. T. T is for how thankful you will be for getting through the terrible twos twice, but only to discover that age three is even tougher. H. H is for all the help you will need in raising your adorable twins. E. E is for all the exhaustion and expertise you will experience in toilet training. And finally, this comes as no surprise, R. R is for Rosemary and your remarkable lifelong job called motherhood, which I promise you will survive. Good luck and congratulations on your two precious bundles of joy.
Okay. I actually brought a couple of things that I was going to share with Aunt Rosie and Madeline and, for the 70th birthday party, but I'm just going to share with all of you. Okay. Now, there is a saying, a poem that I just would like to read to you that I've been looking at for the past 5 years, no joke, about the time coming. I think all of you have helped me get here by giving me the support and love that each and every one of you did in your own different way, believing in me. I watched each and every one of you to see how important this day would be for me. And I also had my grandmother, who, rest in peace, she passed away 2 days after Christmas this year. She made it to her 100th birthday that she wanted in August. And it's amazing. I remember when this little one was about to be born. It's young and Madeline's little girl, as well as when Jackie was expecting her daughter Elizabeth. Went to Madeline's baby shower, and Grandma said to me, she says, you have to be the next one.
Yeah.
She was very adamant. Yeah, she was very, very adamant about it. And I said, but Grandma, you have two great grandchildren on the way. She says, yes, I know. And they already know how great it is to be a mom. But you have to experience it for yourself. It was so important. And she pretty much made sure. She heckled me for 5 years. And I said, don't worry, Grandma, that time will come. Well, I was very, very proud that finally, when the time came in December, her last few days, thank God my grandmother had all her faculties at 100 years old. I mean, she couldn't speak too well, her days were coming, but it meant so much to me to be able to tell her in her hospital bed, holding my mother's hand, that Grandma was expecting twins. And she understood. She saw the sonogram, and this lady, she couldn't talk, but you'll never forget the grip of her hand. It was so tight. When my grandmother shook your hand, she meant business, and I will never forget to this day. And I feel like her spirit's going to guide me. Now, this is something for everybody that I think would be good for everyone to think about. It's a poem called Dream Big, and it's by this lady, Joyce Goliath. If ever there were a time to dare to make a difference, to to do something really worth doing, that time is now. Not for any grand cause necessarily, but for something that tugs at your heart. Something that's your aspiration, something that's your dream. You owe it to yourself to make your days here count. Have fun, dig deep, stretch, and dream big. Know that things worth doing seldom come easily. There will be good days, and there will probably be bad days. There will be times when you want to turn around, pack it up, and call it quits. Those times only come to tell you that you are pushing yourself and that you are not afraid to learn and grow. Persist. Because with an idea, determination, and the right tools, you can do great things. Let your instincts, your intellect, and your heart guide you. Trust. Trust in the ones you love. Believe in the incredible power of the human mind and the power of doing things that really make a difference. Working hard, of laughing and hoping and reaching out and saying, I love you, of lasting friends, all of you here today. Of all the things that will cross your path this year. The start of something new brings hope of something great. Anything is possible. Trust me, it is. Anything is possible. There is only one you. Live your dream and make a difference.
Yes, we got number two! The one that didn't show up! I'm gonna do it again!
My dear friend Chris from
Doesn't she have to get in here?
Yeah, let's see you if should get in here.
Let's see if we can get... Sit down, Mandy. No, we can't have this stuff.
Wow, that's incredible.
Okay, well,
what a beautiful
thing. Here we go. Get a little closer, like scoot down a little bit, maybe, yeah. Right? Nice.
All right, Roll, look here for a minute, Roll.
Wait, I'm sorry. Okay, let's try that again. Ready? Smile. And so, because of that, I want everything that was possible, everything we're trying to be more developed. And this is, we didn't know how to do it.
You're gonna need muscles to
You're gonna need muscle, yeah.
You need a little motor.
I don't know.